associated with the Sobha family for the last 19 years. If precisely, I joined the company in 2001. Till then, I was working in Middle East. Actually, I am heading the team. Actually, it is a separate business vertical of Sobha. Deal with doors and windows for the realty sector and glass facade and metalwork for the commercial buildings. My team, in terms of staff strength, we have around 150. And technicians and all together, we are a team of around 1,200. The division is from 2000 onwards, where we started giving services to the outside for contracting also. But for reality, our in-house sector, we are serving this area for the last 20 years. From 2000 onwards, we are giving doors and windows to the division. If you go back in 2000, if you see the contracting business in the country, where a main contractor will be there, they will be providing the civil structure, and everything subcontract. So that control over the subcontractor was very poor. So when we set up this and we started real estate in serious manner, PNC Menon decided to have our own vertical so that we will have a better control. His idea was to have the right product on right time, where this was helping that cause actually. So that backward integration is very unique model for Sobha, and it is a very thought out process. It is not happen accidentally. The most important aspect is to bring a best product, quality product on right time, and the coordination among the people. We know each other very well, and the same team is working for different projects. Result will be better. We are not associated with unknown contractors, subcontractors. We are usually not dealing with such people. So the best part is the best coordination. Actually, we are helping them, or this entire model is helping them to have the best product, and it will be on the right time, and it is adding a lot of value to them. We will not abuse the sequence of the products. Sometimes subcontractor will come very late, they hurry, and they will make the product not usable, or it is not the quality that what we are looking for. So we know the product, what time it has to come, and what is the sequence we have to follow. That we are very strict, and it is adding a lot of value to the customer end of the day. We source our raw material outside. Definitely we have to source aluminium extrusions and glass, but fortunately we have our own systems. So this raw material I cannot go from the market and buy. It is produced by our own listed vendors and designed by ourselves. So it is usually it will not be available in the market for others. These are all customized products, and it is well designed products actually. Our major role coming to real estate sector, we have doors, windows, ventilators, the main three areas of volume. And we provide metalwork like grill, staircase railings, balcony glass railings. And whenever we have clubhouses and such big areas, we have skylights, all metal requirement and glass requirement pertaining to building industry, we are capable of manufacturing. Coming back to aluminium, it's durability. It is, you know, building industry in the country, we are looking for around 80 years of durability for the building. Because this, our weather is good, concrete building will last for around 80 years, not like in Middle East where after 15 years building go. So to sustain such a condition, durability, in the area of durability, aluminium windows, aluminium is the best. It will not corrode, and it is lightweight, and it can take any finish, powder coating and all. It is a nice product actually, and recycling values are also very high. If you see UPVC, its recycling value is very poor, and you know this plastic kind of products creating a lot of trouble in the country and or in the world. So in that area also we are well placed, better placed. Contractual product, actually in the areas of contractual projects, we are not providing these windows and doors. We want to keep this for our USP. But we are providing lot of building facades for commercial buildings where values are high, where our in that area also we have sufficient expertise. Actually, we practice certain things which I want to express here with proud, that we do value engineering for the customers with a lot of transparency. So we never expect any return for that. whether to Sobha in-house or to other clients, we do lot of value engineering with the transparency, which add lot of value to the customer. Whether it is Sobha or to our apartment owners, or see, when we get a product requirement, it may be a very crude form where client or their consultant may not have that much expertise in the area. So they may ask for something which really they are not looking for at the end of the day. So we'll help them through the journey. We'll offer them what are the changes we can provide, which are the areas where we can bring down the wastage, we can bring down the cost, easily we can bring up the quality, and it may fit to the sequence of the project what is happening. So that areas, our 20 years of experience, we are freely providing to the customers. That is what our USP actually, value engineering is the transparency. We have competitors, if you look back, this area was not organized. In the area of doors, windows, structural glazing or building facades was not organized. Today, a lot of refining happened. Today, people are there. As like in real estate, we are number one, people are there to follow. And many areas they are following up, so that it is a good thing for the country, where we are day by day, the area is getting cleaned and it adding lot of values to the industry as a whole. We have a dream of making this window and door as a product, where like in Europe, you can go and buy this product, customized product. It will come with a pack, and we will make expertise to deal with this for fixing and all. So customer can have the product. So a lot of standardization required. Slowly we are bringing down this. Actually, if you look in Sobha, our lot of window products are standardized now. So it's a beginning where if we go little more further, we can standardize this as a product where W1, a window, will come with a particular size with a tag, and the building owner or the client or their architect know this particular product is available, they can design the opening according to this. Like any other areas, this area is also dynamic, where from the statutory point of view also, lot of building norms are changing day by day. If you see the last building code, lot of stringent norms are introduced, and slowly country is moving towards a green initiative area, where this windows, doors and facade playing a pivotal role. So we need to be dynamic, and we need to see the changes and adapt ourselves. Otherwise, slowly any player in this area will be thrown out from the market. You see, whether it is a window or in a commercial building, the entire facade is going to be glass. So it should be like a skin for the human body. It should allow certain things, it should not allow certain things, where in terms of energy, heat insulation, transparency, light transmission. So if we plan properly this facade, you will have sufficient daylighting in the building, so you need not to use artificial lights. Thermally also your AC load will be very less, and believe me, this is going to be the norm for the whole country. It demands. So it will reduce the pollution, it will reduce the energy consumption. Energy consumption less means it is energy saved. Lot of changes happening in this facade industry, where we are aware of and we are running ahead of other players. It is 100% recyclable. So when you have to have a new glass, 20-25% of the raw material is the old glass only. So it is creating a space that everything can be consumed. I am telling, whatever, country is growing, the demand is growing. So whenever we grow demand like this, the 25% I took the number may not be that right, but entire glass can be recycled. As I told you earlier, country is moving towards a green initiative area where lot of energy refinement is happening. In that aspect, this particular doors and windows, especially window and facade, playing a pivotal role. We can have lot of choices in the glass to make energy consumption as low as possible. Even we have glass today where it can change its characteristics as per our mood. When we do like this or when we switch here, the glass will become opaque or it become transparent. So this is going to be very important. It will play a very important role in the future. See, for the 20 years what we, you see our growth, we started providing services in Bangalore. Slowly we start taking south as our, entire south as our challenge. We started a unit in Chennai. Then currently we have a unit in north also, Delhi we have a unit. So the idea is to serve the country north to south and east to west. That is what the idea. In terms of number, this division may become a unit of 500 crore business within 3 to 4 years time. We have to grow with the country. This country is a growing country in terms of all realty sector and commercial sector. Commercial demand is very high, building industry is doing well. So we want to grow with them to serve the country. See, again, I will take you back 20 years where customers don't know what they want. Today, organization like Sobha established or empowered the customers to educate them for demanding what the quality product is. Now, almost you see young customers or IT, major IT customers, today they know what they want. So what I'm telling you, demand for it, you will get it. That is what the message. We are also having strength in PEB, pre-engineered buildings, where it took a second seat when we deal with the facades. That area also challenging area where when the country become a developed nation, lot of demands will come in that area, because you see in Bangalore city, one building has to be replaced with a building we have to demolish and we have to make one new building. We cannot think about a concrete building at that point of time. We have to think about pre-engineered building where we will use steel and other metal and glass. Where that area expertise we have, we may pursue that area as well. We have done lot of factories. It is a beginning of pre-engineered buildings. It is a entry for the pre-engineered buildings, and we are working on that area to make a full-fledged pre-engineered. See, when they appreciate and when they realize that the value engineering we have provided with a lot of transparency help them to achieve their best within their budget. When they express that, that is the biggest satisfaction what we have. If I take one person's name, it is none other than PNC Menon. He gave lot of inspiration at the beginning, and he inspired me to create a model where the office is like a house. It is like a home where we know each other, and many of my division employees are 20 years plus. So that strength that is the biggest strength I feel I have. See, that bonding, I don't know whether it is my strength or weakness. I am always with them. I never do a bossing over them. So we also allow them to grow with us. All are equally treated. And believe me, in my cabin, even a worker, we have 1,200 workers. Out of that, 250 people are working in the factory itself. Anybody can walk in and they can express their difficulty, problems, and we are there to sort it out.